عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما, he was going to Mecca for Hajj from Medina. And he had his khadim, servant with him. While he was traveling, he saw an Arabi, he saw a Bedouin. So when he saw him, he said, "Anta fulan ibn fulan? Are you so and so, the son of so and so?" So the man said, "Yes." So Abdullah ibn Umar stepped down from his donkey and he said, "This is my donkey as a gift to you." And he took his amama, he took his turban, and he gave it to him and he said, "Amsik biha ra'sak. This is a gift from me to you also." So the servant with him said, "Ya ibn Umar, yeah. These are Arabi, these are Bedouins. يردون بالقليل. If you give them some food, some water, he will be satisfied. The donkey, how are we going to come back from Hajj? The donkey and your amama." Listen, he said, his father used to be close and beloved by my father Umar. And I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, "Inna abar al-bir an yasil al-rajul wudda abih." His father was very close to my father Umar, and I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "The best and the highest level of bir is for the person to connect and have good relationship with his father's friends." Just two quick points about this hadith. First, from the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jal, from the rahmah of Allah Azza wa Jal, is that he made the birr does not stop with the death of the parents. We all know that the birr, as long as they are alive, is absolutely better. They want to see it. They want to feel what you have done for them. But sometimes, just like most of us, مقصرين, we are behind in our duties to our parents. So Allah Azza wa Jal did not close the door for us. He gave us an opportunity even after their death to have birr to them. And that is more sincere, by the way, because you're not getting anything in return. You're not seeing the smile on your father's face. You're just having pure iman in what Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said. Your father had a friend. Your mother had a very close sister. After they pass away, these are the people you want to connect with. You want to be friends with. You want to pick up the phone and call up and check up on them. Abdullah ibn Umar did this to the son of the man. Maybe this son never seen Umar. Just because his father was a friend with my father. And the closest, for example, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Al-khala bimartabati al-ummah." The khala, the mother's sister, is the same level as the mother. So after the mother passes, if you still have a khala, make sure you do as much birr to her as possible. And we all know the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the woman walked in and he started being very kind and checking up on her. And then Aisha said, "I noticed that you've been so kind to her. How come?" He said, "She used to be very close to Khadija radiallahu anha." Subhanallah. Yani, when someone is very close to you and they had people that are close to them, after they pass, stay connected with them if you would like to make, to have birr for your parents. Imagine, ya akhwan, this is what Abdullah ibn Umar, after he did, after his father passed away. And unfortunately, many of us appreciate the father, appreciate the mother after they leave. So if your mother or father are still alive, wallahi, take advantage before they are gone. Make sure you're pleasing them and make sure they are happy and they are pleased with you. Second quick point. Many times when we give gifts or do something kind, we do it to the elite of the community. This is the Amir of the Masjid, this is the Imam, this is the Ustaz, this is the Sheikh, this guy is a big donor, this guy is an Arabi. He's a Bedouin, very simple man. Like the man said, he could have been satisfied with just a small piece of bread or a drink of water. So when we are being nice, we have to be nice with everybody. It's not about the status of the person. It's about you. This is your akhlaq. Your akhlaq does not depend on the person that you're talking to. Your akhlaq is your akhlaq. And finally, many people, I hear it all the time, you see them very harsh and always frowning. You hardly get a smile out of them. And when you ask them, ya akhi, why? You are a mashallah muttaqi, you look. He said, هذا طبعي وأبوي كان هيك نفس الشيء وجدي كان هيك نفس الشيء. This is the way I am. Even my father was like this and my grandfather. And he's proud. Yani he's bring, you know, when somebody is proud, he bring back his lineage. He's proud of it. Yani. Not me. No. Even if you had that in your family or in you, this can be changed. This can be improved. Even the lion, the lion is a fierce animal. After you train him, subhanAllah, how many times we saw that video of the animal hugging the person who was kind to him. So yani, by training, you can improve. By training, you can become better. إِنَّمَا الْحِلْمُ بِالتَّحَلُّمُ وَإِنَّمَا الصَّبْرُ بِالتَّصَبُّرُ. If you want to do something, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, train yourself about that thing, strive, jahid, and you will be able to achieve that trait. SubhanAllah. May Allah make us from the people who have bitter to their parents. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make them pleased with us. And another thing I want to tell you is, tell Allah Azza wa Jal, Ya Allah, I am pleased with my children. Tell Allah, I am pleased with my children. So Ya Allah, be pleased with them. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, رِضَ الرَّبِّ مِنْ رِضَ الْأَبِّ. The pleasure of Allah is from the pleasure of the Father. جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
إن المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والقانتين والقانتات والصادقين والصادقات والصابرين والصابرات والخاشعين والخاشعات والخاشعين والخاشعات والمتصدقين والمتصدقات والصائمين والصائمات والحافظين فروجهم والحافظات والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيماً.